बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, होप ऑल ऑफ़ यू विल बी फाइन। इट्स टाइम टू लर्न काउंटडाउन। ओपन योर काउंटडाउन बुक 2। स्टूडेंट्स, वी वर रिवाइजिंग द चैप्टर नंबर 2, दैट इज़ एडिशन। टुडे वी विल रिवाइज पेज नंबर 38 एंड पेज नंबर 39। आर टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज़ एडिशन, converting tens and hundreds. Students, as we have learned before, addition and the converting of ones. Today we will learn about the converting of tens and hundreds. Look students, Adil have 999 blocks. What will be happen when Adil adds one more block to 999 blocks? Here is Adil and he is going to add one more block to 999 block. Students, as we know that we can change ones and also we can change tens and hundreds. Look, here is Adil's sum. Adil have 999 blocks and he is adding one more block to it. Look students, we will follow the same process of addition, starting from the ones and then a carry to the tens and from the tens to the hundreds. Let's try to solve it from the ones side. Look students, when we add the number 9 and the 1, our answer is 10. We can't write the 10 in the ones column whole. So we will take the 10 and we will change our 10 into ones and tens. The 0 that is in ones column will be written in the ones and 1 will be carried into the tens column. Just look in this sum, we have written the 0 of the 10 into the ones column and 1 is taken as a carry into the tens column. So we have solved our ones column. Next step is the solution for the tens column. Now we will add this number 9 and the carry from the ones column. So when we add 9 and 1, our answer will be 10. So students, what can we do to solve this part? 9 and 1 is 10. So we will write the 0 here and 1 will be taken into the hundreds column. Okay, 1 will be 0 will be written here and 1 will be taken into the hundreds column. Look students, we have written the 0 here and 1 will be taken as a carry into the hundreds column. So in the next step we will do the same process. We will add this 9 and 1, that will be equal to 10. How can we write the 10 in the hundreds column? Look students, Adil changed the 10 tens into 100s. Now in the 100s, if we add one more, it will be equal to the 10 hundreds. How can we write the 10 hundreds? Now look students, Adil will change his 10 hundreds into 1000. Here is the new number, that is 1000, that can be written under the thousands column. Okay, so we have solved our ones column and a carry to the tens column. After solving the tens, one carry to the hundred, here we get the 10 hundreds and 1 is taken into the 1000 column. So here we have the 1000. There are the things you will have to remember students. When we add one more block into 9 blocks, that will be equal to 10 and 0 will be come into 1s and 1 will be taken as the tens. And if we have the 99 blocks and we add one more block into it, that will be equal the number 100. And here we have this one into ones, this zero into tens, and this one into hundreds. And if here we have completed the nine figures that are 999, and we add one more block into it, then it will become a new word that is thousand. Ones, tens, hundreds, and thousand. Students, now open your page number 39. And our topic is think and solve. We will have to think and solve these questions. Look, students, here in your book, there are three kids showing their numbers, showing their mark sheets. And we can count the total numbers of each kid by adding the numbers in the two sheets. Okay, for example, for the Amir's total number, we will add the two numbers in the two sheets. Okay, we will add the numbers 24 and 23 to get the total numbers of Amir. Same is that for Alia and Majid. Here is our first question. Which child has the lowest score? To find out the lowest and the highest score, we will have to find out the total score of each student. Okay, for this we will add the numbers of each student one by one. Let's start from the Amir. For the Amir, here he have the 24 and here he has 23. So we will add the ones first. Ones, here ones is 3 and here ones is 4. So we will add 4 and 3. Our answer will be 7. I am writing total numbers here. The next is tens. In the tens, here we have the 2 and here we have the 2. So we will add the numbers 2 and 2, and total numbers will be 4. So Amir's total numbers are 47. Next is for Alia. To count the marks for the Alia, we will count from the ones. Here is 5 and here is 5. If I add 5 and 5, we get the number 10. Here I am writing her numbers 1, and 1 will be taken as a carry into the tens. 4 and 2, 4, 5, 6 and 1 carry 7. So Alia has 70 total marks. Counting it for Majid, here I am starting from the ones side. 0 and 3, no effect. So we will write the 3 here. Next is for the tens. 5 and 2. 5, 6 and 7. So Majid's total score will be 73. Majid's total score is 73. Alia's score is 70. While Amir's score is 47. So which child has the lowest score? Tell me, students. Which number is the lowest, 73, 70 or the 47? Yes, 47. 47 is the lowest score. So Amir has the lowest score. Look, students, here I have written the name of Amir because Amir has the lowest score. Next is, which child has the highest score? So students, tell me which child has the highest score. Amir has the lowest. Alia and Majid. Alia has 70 while Majid has 73. So Majid have the highest score. We will write the name of Majid in the second question. Look, students, we have written the name of Majid in the highest score. Next is, whose score is nearest to Majid? Let us compare the numbers of each children. Majid has 73 score, Alia has 70 scores, and Amir has 47 scores. For this, we will compare the three numbers here. We will start comparison from the tens side. In the tens, the greater number is 7. As these two numbers have the same tens, here we will compare the ones. In the ones column, 3 is greater, so 73 is the greater number, and 70 having the same tens is closer to 73 as compared to 47. It means that 73 is closer to 70, and 70 are the marks for the Alia. So whose score is nearest to Majid? Alia's score. We will write Alia here. Students, next is D. Amir is short of 50 marks by which number? Amir's marks are 47, while here 50 marks are given. So we will count the number by subtracting it. Here we will write the number 50 and 47. Look students, we will start subtraction from the one side. From the one side, look here, we have the 0. And we can't subtract 7 from the 0. So we will take 1 carry from the 5. And here become the number 10. And here we left with the number 4. Okay students, so now we can subtract 7 from the number 10. When we subtract 7 from the number 10, we get 3. And when we subtract 4 from the 4, then answer is 0. So when we subtract 47 from the number 50, we get the number 3. So Amir is short of 50 marks by the number 3. Here is our answer. Next is E. What is Alia's score? As we have calculated the total marks of each student, so Alia's score are 70. Here is the Alia's score that are 70. Next is, what is the total score obtained by Amir, Alia and Majid? For the total score obtained by Amir, Alia and Majid, we will add the scores of each child, 47, 70 and 73. Look here, I am adding the numbers 73, 70 and 47. Let's start addition from the one side. Here we have the number 7 and the number 3. So when we add 7 and 3, answer is 10. We will write the 0 of the 10 here, and 1 will be taken as carry into the tens column. So now we will add these tens column numbers and this carry. 7, 7, 4 and 1. When we add all these numbers, we get the number 19. We will write the 9 here, and 1 will be written in the hundreds column. So when we add Majid, Amir and Alia's marks, we get the number 190. So students, the total score obtained by three of the students will be 190. Look, we have solved our first part. Here is our second question. I have 37 marbles and Seema has 26 marbles. Okay students, I have 37 marbles while Seema has 26 marbles. The question is that, how many more marbles have I than Seema? Students, we can find the answer by finding the difference between the two numbers. For the difference, we will subtract the number 37 from the number 26. Here I have written the number 37 and 26. We will start subtraction from the one side. When we subtract 6 from the number 7, we get the number 1. And here, when we subtract the number 3 from number 2, we get 1. So, we have 11 more marbles than the Seema. We will write the number here. Look, students, I have 11 more marbles than Seema. Our next part is how many do we have altogether? Here is the word altogether. I am underlining the word altogether. Altogether is a word showing that this sum will be solved by the addition. Here I have two words, 37 and 26. I am adding these two numbers in this way. When I do the addition from the ones column, I will add the number 7 and the 6. And our answer is 13. I have written the 3 in the ones column and 1 is taken as a carry into the tens column. Now I will add these numbers and the carry, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So when we add the number 37 and 26, we get the number 63. So I and Seema have 63 marbles altogether. Next is how many more do we need to make 100? How many more marbles do we need to make the 100 marbles? So we can find out the number of marbles that we need to make 100 by subtracting the number 100 and 63. Look, student, here I am subtracting the number 63 from 100. I can't subtract 3 from the number 0, so I will take the carry from the other number. Other number is also 0, so carry will be taken from hundreds. Here I will carry 1 and this will become 10. I will take carry from this 10 and this will become 10 and the previous will become 9. Okay, students. Now I am subtracting 3 from the number 10. Here I get the number 7. Here is the number 9. When I subtract 6 from the 9, I get the number 3. As we have taken carry from this, so here we remain with the 0. We have solved our question. When we subtract 63 from number 100, we get the answer 37. So students, we need 37 more marbles to make our marbles 100. That was the question 2. We have solved our second question. Here is our third question. 12 goldfish were taken from a fish tank to be sold at the shop. It means that there is a fish tank and we have taken 12 goldfish from that tank to the shop. Next is, this left 14 fish in the tank. 12 are sold out and remaining fishes are 14. So what is our question? Our question is that how many fish were there to start with? When it was started, how many fishes were there? How can we count? How can we find out the fishes when that was started? Students, here I am underlining the words. Look, I found the words 12 and 14. By adding these two words, we can find out the total number of fishes. 14 fishes were left while 12 were sold out. We can find the total fishes by adding these two numbers. We will start addition from the one side. Here we have the number 4 and the 2. 4, 5 and 6. Here is the number 6. 1 and 1. Here is the number 2. So the total number of fishes that were in the tank is 26. Look students, we have solved our third question. Hope this will be clear to you and very helpful for you. Okay students, Allah Hafiz.